He had a bag with him, and there was a controlled explosion over concerns about what might be in that bag. We're now told that it's being treated as a mental health episode rather than an attempted terror attack, but concerns obviously about royal security. Let's talk to former head of royal protection, Di Davies. Good morning to you, Di.
Good morning to you.
Thank you very much indeed. Obviously, big concern after events last night, particularly with the controlled explosion and concerns. Are the royals, can they be protected? Can they be kept safe in Buckingham Palace and other palaces, particularly a palace like Buckingham Palace, which is in the centre of a big city?
Yeah, well, the answer, plain answer, is yes. They can be, and that's why you have literally hundreds of policemen and women actually doing that job, not only at Buckingham Palace, Windsor and all the other castles and homes that they have. So, yes, they can be. You can never be 100%, as we know with Fagin, who got into the late Queen's yeah. bedroom. I hope things have improved tremendously since then. But this is a case which I often speak about, which is those who are mentally ill, sadly, or fixated. And this poor chap clearly is mentally ill, because to do what he has done in full sight with literally hundreds of police officers there shows that there's something wrong. And he may or may not be on what's known as the Fixated Threat Assessment Centre, where we are told there are up to 200 those seriously considered to be a problem, and about 10% of them are considered extremely dangerous. So yeah. The police have acted quickly, succinctly, and I hope they continue to do that against any threat in whatever form comes on the King's coronation.
Yeah. I mean, you know, the Fagin actually walking into the Queen's bedroom, that was an extraordinary breach of security, wasn't it? And it was featured in the last series of The Crown as well. It was extraordinary, front page news for a very long time. The reality is, you know, I could walk along outside Buckingham Palace and throw something over the gate. You know, no one's going to be stopping people unless you're going to be searching people for miles around. Or having cordons up miles around. People stand at the gates. We see, you know, changing of the guard. We see the tourists. We see people crowding out there from any major event, whether it is a sad event like the Queen's funeral or for a royal wedding or the coronation this weekend. There is an element where, you know, the royals need to be relatively close to the people. We have seen a sort of an upgrading of events, you know, the throwing of the eggs at King Charles. And again, whatever one's views on the monarchy, you know, you can't... An egg is a missile. You cannot throw things at people just because you disagree with their job or what they think about anything. Are you concerned for what's going to happen with the coronation? Or are we, I mean, we know like Parliament's ending today after PMQs, and we know that, you know, lots of streets in central London around the Abbey are going effectively into lockdown, being closed off, that actually the security is going to be so tight in the coming days ahead of the coronation that there's nothing to fear?
Well, the Metropolitan Police, or whatever other ills they have, are particularly good at these large ceremonial, as yeah. we've seen over the years. So I give them that, and they will have been working for months with other agencies, the military, intelligence, and all the rest of it. What I would be doing is looking at pinch points where I think a possible incident could take place. I'd be looking at my contingency plans. Should there be a major incident, how do I evacuate not only the royals, but the VIPs, and indeed the good old British public? Many thousands will be there. So you've got 101 things as the overall commander to actually look at and to prepare. And I humbly hope that they have done so. And I have every regard that they have done it once yeah. again to the best of their ability.
And as always with security, actually, you don't see the real security that's going on, the searching of buildings, of rooftops, of the sewers, of the post boxes that are sealed up. There's so much that goes on. I mean, there's literally an army of people that are involved in making these routes safe. Can I ask you, though, in terms of the royal families, you know, personalities, we've seen, you know, there are threats to the life of any major figure in the royal family. We know that they're under risk of terror threats. One thing I've always agreed with Prince Harry on, I think he has a right to have, you know, that security, that care, because he fought in Afghanistan. It's not his fault. He was born a royal prince. But, you know, we had Princess Anne. There was that, you know, kidnap attempt many years ago when she was younger. Do they live day to day in fearing, with concern about either a terror attack or, you know, just some mentally ill person coming for them. Is that something, or do they just say, look, you know, this is the life I'm in a goldfish bowl, the security is around me? I mean, have you ever had a conversation with any of the royals you were protecting? Were they told you what they thought?
Well, I personally didn't go out and protect them. I was the OCU commander. Yeah. But of course, I had conversations, and of course, I had conversations with the teams. And that's the key word. They have excellent men and women, more women now than when I did it, who actually work with them day in, day out.
Yeah.
And they rely on those men and women, and they are exceptional people who are highly trained. And no, I don't think they've all been brought up with this since they were babies. So the truth is, they take it as you and I do with breathing. They take it, as far as I understand it, as part of life.
Part of the job. And what do you make of protests? They're the likes of, you know, Just Stop Oil or the anti-monarchy group Republic, whether it's someone holding up signs or whether it's somebody, gluing themselves to a police horse or something. How big a threat is that?
Well, again, it's something that's a relatively new one this time in terms of protests, because we've seen for the last year, and as I understand it, legislation has been rushed through.
Yep.
Whether it's come actually into legality today, I don't know, but I read somewhere this morning in the Telegraph that they actually have fast-forwarded.
Yeah, they've fast-forwarded as of today. Well, we'll see if that has an impact. Di Davies, former head of Royal Protection, so appreciate your time. Well,